Hello and welcome back to Android tutorials. And in our previous video, we had implemented on navigation item selected in our navigation drawer. Now it's time to move to another part of our application. But before that, I want to complete our dashboard design. So to complete our dashboard design, I had planned to add the share and rate as button in our toolbar. So let's implement that. So first, go to menu. Then click on new menu resource file and type the menu and then click on OK. So when you click on OK, you will find the new menu file. And now come to dashboard activity, and here we have to create so on create menu option item selected, and here we have to inflate our menu. So get menu inflator dot inflate, then pass our menu, which is menu dot menu, and then write our parameter menu. So here we had casted it. So after you write that code, you have to again come to our menu part and write the two items here. So first item will be our share button and second will be rate button. So first item, let me zoom our code. So here I had zoom our code and you will find the title. So here we have to write the title. So I had written title as a share, then ID also share, and gave its icon. So our icon will be share, then give its show as action. So show as action will be always, and then type on click. So here we have to write on share, and then complete this code, and then copy this full, or we can write manually. So let's write manually item. Title of that will be menu will be rate, then set the icon. So icon will be rate, and then show as action always, then its ID will be rate, and its on click will be on rate. So here we had created our this much item. Now we have to click on this on click and then create that menu item here, and then again click on this and create on rate menu click listener. So here we had created that both method, and then we have to write our code. So first code will be the share button. So we are going to copy this complete share code here. So you can see that intent is equal to new of intent, and that intent will be intent dot action send, and then pass the type of our intent. So intent dot set type, and then pass plain slash text. Then we are going to write our string. So you can see this string here, and then I had pasted that string again. So here we had implemented that string, and then put this string in our intent. So intent dot put extra, and then give string name. So string name will be intent dot extra text, and then pass our share link, and then we are going to start our activity intent. So this was our code for sharing purpose, and now third code is rate code is intent or first write URI. URI is equal to URI dot phrase. Then pass the complete string. So you can see that here is our complete string. So paste it here and remove this slash, and you will resolve the error and erase this also. And then complete this URI, and then we have to start intent. So first write intent. Intent is equal to new intent, and then write our action view. So first write intent dot action send not view, and then pass the URI. And then we have to copy this or start activity intent. So here we had completed the implementation of on create options menu and on share on write options, but we are going to see that code in just our dashboard activity. So let's implement that in our camera activity and in our camera activity and image activity. So first open our dashboard activity and copy that toolbar that we have created in our previous video. So copy that toolbar, and as we don't have any toolbar, as we had declared our theme with no action bar, so we have to write all the toolbars manually. So here we had implemented that toolbar. So this will generate an error because it is constraint layout. So change it to be linear layout. We are also going to design this result activity in our upcoming video. So subscribe to our YouTube channel and our tutorials if you are enjoying this video. So here we declare our toolbar. Now come to the camera activity, or first click on dashboard activity. And if you don't know how to implement the custom toolbar, then you can watch our previous Android tutorials where you will find all the things. So here I had copied this much code and then write in it in the camera activity. So here we had pasted, so it will generate an error. So we have to write toolbar and then toolbar. So our activity is resolved, but title will be, so as this is camera result, so we are going to write camera result. And if you want the subtitles, then you can use this line of code, but change that subtitle to OCR text scan result, or whatever you want as a subtitle. But we are not going to use this subtitle, so I am commenting it that, and then implement that full code that we had created in this video. So copy this code from here to here, so we will find this code in our camera activity. Now to implement this same code in our image activity, we are going to copy this full layout over there. So let's begin. So first click on image activity, and then again click on camera activity and copy this full code and write here. And then we have to again come to camera activity and copy this toolbar code and type it in the image activity. So here is our image activity. So write this code in here, and again this will generate an error. So we have to write toolbar. Don't import the wrong toolbar. So here by mistake I had import the wrong toolbar. So here is the right toolbar. So let me show you what is wrong toolbar and right toolbar. So when you implement this toolbar, then it is better. But when you implement any other toolbar like this, then this will generate an error. So don't use this toolbar. Just use our this Android X library widget toolbar. So again I am writing, you can see that this second toolbar. So after implementing this toolbar, you will see the share button and like button. But to implement the back button, we have to again redirect to manifest file. Then let me zoom our code. And when you completed this full implementation of activity, then you have to write here one attribute that name is parent activity name and give it as a dashboard activity. And then again in the image activity, we have to write parent activity name to dashboard activity. So here you can see that we have created the toolbar with share and latest button. If you had enjoyed our content, then please make sure you hit the like button and share with your friends. Don't forget to subscribe our YouTube channel to learn more Android tutorials. Thanks for watching.